Hello, I'm John Kane. Welcome to the first in a series of video piano masterclasses aimed at increasing the effectiveness of practicing. Designed for all ages and levels, the sooner the better to be aware of how to improve results from the time we spend practicing. Let's face it, for countless hours, serious piano students sit alone at the keyboard trying to perfect the music at hand. All too often, slow or no progress is made. Instead, we become disillusioned by the monotony of doing the same thing over and over again, day after day after day. And while repetition has its place in practicing, there are many alternative methods that I believe deliver results faster and better. Creatively thinking about new and different ways to practice will not only produce more solid results quicker for the task at hand, but will also develop critical problem-solving skills, which can be employed for a lifetime, broaden and strengthen one's own listening abilities, hone important pianistic and musical capabilities applicable throughout the repertoire, and maintain focus, interest, and enthusiasm during practice. The purpose of this video is to briefly introduce and demonstrate a number of different ways of practicing commonly encountered musical challenges. These concepts are what should be in mind when you open a piece of music and are ready to begin learning, improving, and perfecting it. This video is not intended to prescribe how much or frequently one should practice, how to position or move the hands or wrists or the curvature of fingers when playing the piano, specific fingering used in the examples, or particular interpretations. The passages here are merely meant to illustrate how to apply the creative thinking process to real situations. Before we get started, a few general comments. Obviously, practicing is a highly personal and individualistic endeavor. Different approaches have varying effects on different people. It is precisely in this spirit that this video is created. Effective practicing itself is a vital ingredient to future success in music. Being actively engaged in thinking about what you're doing while practicing will go much farther than the mere rote muscle memory that results from endless and mindless repetition. Again, the objective of this video masterclass is to show how creative and sometimes counterintuitive practicing approaches and techniques can dramatically improve results while building other important problem-solving and pianistic musical skills. I'm a believer in slow practice. If you can't play something slowly, you can't play it fast, a tempo. And I'm not just talking about the notes themselves, but all the aspects of playing, dynamics, phrasing, and so forth. Thus, things will be demonstrated slowly here, and I recommend you practice slowly as well. Do not use pedal with these alternative approaches. Let the fingers do the work. So don't introduce any exaggerated motions in the arms and hands to accomplish these various ways. And always be thinking about exactly what you're doing and how to produce the sound. By mixing it up and not playing it in the so-called normal way, you get your brain to really engage in thinking about completely different ways of executing and listening to these passages. Again, the point of this video is not to convey proper physical technique, bench height, fingering, or ultimate interpretations of the pieces demonstrated. Its purpose is to introduce and demonstrate creative problem-solving techniques that will make practicing much more effective. Let's begin. The first area of creative practice I'd like to share is rhythms. using exaggerated dotted rhythms for passages whose outcome you want to be fast and even, it can be very helpful to practice these passages using exaggerated dotted rhythms. So for example, a scale where the aim is to have fast and even playing. Try practicing it with dotted rhythms that basically go long, short, long, short, long. So alternating long and short notes. And then do the reverse, so you play short, long, short, long. Now notice I am not accenting every other note. I'm not playing. Try to avoid accents. And let the fingers do the work, so I'm not pressing in with my hands. Generally speaking, I'm not going to be moving in and out of the keyboard with the hands, or up and down with the wrists, or in and out with the arms. Keeping the hands and arms very still and letting the fingers do the work. So again, the example in dotted rhythms is it's really like a double or triple dotted rhythm. It's very exaggerated. And the reverse of that. And in addition to doing every other note long and short, it could be every third note that's long. So as an example. Then starting with the second note being the long note. Then with the third note. The idea is that each and every note eventually gets its due as both long and short notes. And the shorter you play the note, the faster and more even it will eventually be when you then go to play it in the normal fashion. So that was scales. Another example is simple hand exercise. Again, we're going to play long and alternate long and short. Reverse of that. Try not to have any accents, just merely long and short. Another example from piano repertoire would be a run in a Chopin A-flat Polonaise. So again, practice it long and short. And then the opposite. Groups of three. Another example is the slow movement of the second piano concerto of Chopin. So to practice this, that's again long, short, and then the reverse, short, long. In groups of three. And so forth.